Hello, my name is Randy Pitts, and I'm the marketing manager of the Intersil Interface product line. Today I'm going to compare the high-speed performance of the ISL 3179E RS-485 transceiver against similar parts from two competitors. This demonstration will show that the Intersil transceiver delivers better signal integrity over a longer distance. For this comparison, we will be running the transceivers at 40 megabits per second, driving 300 foot of double terminated unshielded twisted pair cable. We are using a four pulse burst test as a figure of merit to determine the acceptable transmission distance for these transceivers. Critical parameters are the differential voltage delivered at the far end of the cable and the width of the first pulse out of the receiver. On the left, we have a transmitter board that drives the 300 foot of cable being received by the board on the right. On the screen, we have the results from the first competitor's transceivers. The yellow trace at the top is the transmitter input. The orange trace below that is the differential signal at the receiver end of the cable. The blue and pink traces are the transmitter Y and Z signals at the receiver end of the cable. And the green trace is the receiver output signal. The scope display shows the results for the first competitor. The orange cursors indicate the differential voltage of minus 520 millivolt that is delivered to the receiver. The larger the magnitude of this voltage, the better. The scope now shows the receiver first bit pulse width as indicated by the vertical green cursors. An ideal pulse width would be 25 nanoseconds, which represents a 40 megabit per second data rate. This device measures only 14.4 nanoseconds, which indicates 10.6 nanoseconds of pulse width distortion. We are now showing the results for the second competitor. The orange cursors indicate the differential voltage of minus 560 millivolts that is delivered to the receiver. Once again, the scope shows the receiver first bit pulse width as indicated by the green cursors. This device measures only 16 nanoseconds, which is 9 nanoseconds of distortion. Now let's look at the performance of the Intersil ISL 3179E 40 megabit per second 3.3 volt transceiver. The Intersil device delivers at least a 20% larger differential voltage of minus 680 millivolts delivered to the receiver. The receiver first bit pulse width of 25.6 nanoseconds is only 0.6 nanoseconds from the ideal versus 10.6 nanoseconds and 9 nanoseconds from the competitors. To summarize, the Intersil transceiver delivers 20% larger differential output voltage and less than 1/10 the bit distortion compared to the competition when driving a 300-foot cable. For the best high-speed performance over long cables, we recommend Intersil's ISL 3179E for 3.3 volt applications or the ISL 3159E for 5 volt applications. For more information about Intersil's interface products or to download a datasheet, please visit www.intersil.com/interface. Thank you for watching.